You're watching Good Day Columbus on ABC6.
Describe the field of dreams on 1,000 acres outside of Columbus, Ohio, where America's future will be built.
Right now at 6 a.m., a field of dreams to reality. Intel breaking ground today on a facility that will transform the future of Central Ohio. Here is what that field in Licking County looks like right now. Our drone track flying over the area this week. We are on your side this morning with team coverage of what this project means to our area, from the economic promise it brings to the concerns about the real price of progress. Good morning to all of you. Thank you so much for joining us here live on this Friday morning, September 9th. I'm Jessica Ralston here in Johnstown, where this project is taking place just a few miles down the road. A lot of excitement here as this finally gets underway and we await the arrival of President Biden.
And good morning, I'm Kurt Ludlow. We're going to get to our extensive coverage of Intel's arrival to Central Ohio and President Biden's visit.
Let's take you live to Washington this morning. President Biden will board Air Force One. We're giving you a live look at the White House this hour. His destination right here in Licking County. On the agenda, attending this groundbreaking of the highly anticipated Intel semiconductor chip plant that's being built not far from Johnstown, from where I'm sitting right now. From Washington to the Ohio State House and even right here in Licking County, leaders have been promising that this project is a game changer for our economy. Here is what we've been told about what Intel is building here. The company says it will invest $20 billion in this chip plant. The project will create 3,000 permanent positions. Keep in mind, many of those are high paying in just six figures. Building the plant itself, that will create 7,000 construction jobs. And then there's the ripple effect, the support jobs in restaurants and healthcare, housing, even entertainment. They're hoping to have this facility open here by 2025. So 3 years to go. Intel says the project could only happen, though, with help from the federal government. And President Biden will be here to celebrate not only the facility and his role in making this happen, but also a big win, he says, for his economic agenda. Our Mike McCarthy is live at John Glenn International Airport this morning, where the president will arrive, and he'll be landing there in just a few short hours, Mike. All right, Mike. Well, getting to this day without a doubt has certainly been a journey, and there were obstacles to overcome. Here are some of the big moments that we've been seeing so far. Intel announced it picked Central Ohio just back in January. That's when they made the official decision. The state offered the company incentives worth about $2 billion. Intel then postponed the groundbreaking in June, you might remember, as the CHIPS Act remained stalled in Congress. That put things on hold, but eventually it was passed, and the president signed the act just last month, and that brings us here today to the groundbreaking. As Mike mentioned, the legislation passed by the president includes $52 billion for the semiconductor industry. Intel will get some of that money, although so far we haven't heard exactly how much they will get. And with all things, not everyone is celebrating the arrival of President Biden here in Licking County, Ohio today. Driving around the area, you can see some anti-Biden signs posted along the road. And we've also been told that there will take some, or protests will take place this morning along Beach Road. We will watch out for those as well throughout the morning, and we'll bring you any updates we can throughout the day. We have a lot of team coverage here on Good Day Columbus for you as history takes place in Ohio this morning. Coming up at 6:15, Kate Seifert digging deeper into the mood here in Johnstown and beyond. She talked with community leaders, business and landowners about what they think about the president's visit and Intel's impact. At 6:30, all of this is playing out as the November midterm elections draw near. And Ohio is in the spotlight, do not forget, with a highly competitive U.S. Senate race. We've got it all covered for you. So, Kurt, it is a very big day here. A lot of excitement, not just for Licking County, but for the entire state of Ohio. So that's what's happening here right now. So much more to come. Back to you in the studio.
All right. Thank you, Jessica. 6:08 here.
Continuing coverage now in Johnstown of the groundbreaking of Intel's $20 billion semiconductor plant. It is shining a spotlight on an area that until this point has really been the postcard for small town America. So how do people who live here, who wanted this kind of lifestyle, feel about what will undoubtedly be a seismic change for their community? Kate Seifert caught up with many here, many neighbors who live here, to see how they are feeling about today's presidential visit and what will happen next to their town.
You're watching Good Day Columbus on ABC6.
Right now at 6:30, excitement is building as we await the arrival of Air Force One. President Biden will be touching down here in Central Ohio. A little later on this morning, we have live team coverage of his visit and the big monumental groundbreaking for the Intel plants in Licking County. Good morning to all of you. Thank you so much for joining us here on this Friday, September 9th. I'm Jessica Ralston, live in Johnstown this morning.
And I'm Kurt Ludlow. We're going to get to our team coverage of the Intel groundbreaking and President Biden's visit in just a minute. First, though, let's get to your first warning weather and steer clear teen traffic. Caroline?
Happening today, President Biden's victory lap on several major legislative wins in Congress will come through Central Ohio today. Let's give you a live look at the White House this hour. The president will leave Washington around 9 o'clock this morning. He'll board Air Force One and make his way to the groundbreaking here of Intel's semiconductor plant in Licking County. When he arrives, he'll talk about what his administration is doing to boost American manufacturing. You might remember Intel committed to building the plant here only with help from the federal government, and that funding is coming from the CHIPS Act, which President Biden signed into law just last month to make all of this happen. The president's involvement in this groundbreaking really shows just how major of a moment this is for Ohio. We've talked about history in the making. Mike McCarthy live at John Glenn International, where he is awaiting the president's arrival this morning. Mike, this project no doubt has been a priority on all levels, from Licking County to our state house and then ultimately to the White House. All right, Mike just mentioned it, continuing coverage all day of President Biden's visit to Ohio and this Intel groundbreaking. We will be breaking in with coverage here on ABC 6 as the president arrives there at John Glenn International, and then again when he speaks here in Licking County. If you're going to be away from your TV today and you want to watch, make sure you have the ABC 6 News app on your phone. We'll send out a push alert with live stream straight to your phone the moment things begin. So, Kurt, it is going to be a historic day here in Licking County. A lot of excitement is building from all around. Our coverage continues on Good Day Columbus at 7 o'clock.
The time is 6:57, so it's time to join us on Fox 28 for your only local news until 10 a.m. Here's a look at what's still ahead on your morning menu.
I'm Jessica Ralston, live in Licking County. President Biden getting ready to head here to Johnstown for the groundbreaking of Intel's new chip plant. We are on your side with team coverage of how this project will change our landscape.
Good Day Columbus on Fox 28.
Describe the field of dreams on 1,000 acres outside of Columbus, Ohio, where America's future will be built.
Right now at 7, from a field of dreams to reality, Intel is breaking ground today on a facility that will transform the future of Central Ohio. And here is what that field in Licking County looks like right now. Drone track flying over the area this week. We are on your side this morning with team coverage of what this project means to our area, from the economic promise it is bringing to the concerns about the real price of progress. Good morning to all of you. Thank you for joining us on this Friday, September 9th. I'm Jessica Ralston, live here in Johnstown, where this project is taking place just a few miles down the road. There's a lot of excitement as this gets underway, and also as we await the arrival today of President Biden.
Understandably so, and good morning. I'm Kurt Ludlow. We're going to get to our extensive coverage of Intel's arrival and President Biden's visit to Central Ohio.
The White House this morning where President Biden will board Air Force One from Washington today. His destination here in Lincoln County, Ohio, on his agenda, attending the groundbreaking of the highly anticipated Intel semiconductor chip plant that's being built not far from where I sit right now in Johnstown. And from D.C. to the State House in Ohio and even right here in Lincoln County, leaders have been promising that this project is a game changer for our economy. Here's what we've been told about Intel's plans. The company will invest $20 billion in their chip plant. The project will create 3,000 permanent positions. Building the plant will create 7,000 construction jobs and support jobs. There's a ripple effect here in restaurants, healthcare, housing, even entertainment. Plans are to have this facility open by 2025. Intel said this project could really only happen with help from the federal government. And President Biden will be here to celebrate not only this facility and the groundbreaking, but also a big win for his own economic agenda. Mike McCarthy is live for us this morning at John Glenn International. And Mike, the president will be landing there in just a couple of hours now. Mike, thank you. You know, getting to this day has certainly been a journey. Here are some of the big moments that we've seen so far. Intel announced at Pick Central, Ohio, just back in January. The state offered the company incentives worth about $2 billion. Intel then had to postpone the groundbreaking in June. That's, as Mike mentioned, as that CHIPS Act remained stalled in Congress. It did eventually pass, and the president signed the act last month, bringing us here to today. And as Mike mentioned, the legislation includes $52 billion for the semiconductor industry. Intel is going to get some of that federal funding, although we don't know yet just how much we will get. Now, with that said, not everyone is celebrating the arrival of President Biden here in Lincoln County today. Driving around town, you can see some anti-Biden signs along the road. There's a gentleman across the street from me holding a Donald Trump sign right now at a diner. There will also be protests we're hearing this morning. Those will be along Beach Road. So we're going to watch those throughout the day, and we'll keep you updated. We do have a lot more coverage here on Good Day Columbus this morning. Coming up at 7:15, Kate Seifert digging deeper into the mood in Johnstown. She talked with community leaders, business and landowners about what they think about the president's visit and Intel's impact. Then at 7:30, all of this playing out as the November midterm election looms. And don't forget, Ohio is in the spotlight with a highly competitive U.S. Senate race this year. Kurt, it is a very big day here. Everyone around town is talking. It's not only big for Lincoln County, but really for the entire state of Ohio. I just spoke with a gentleman who came over to say hello to us, and he said there's going to be a lot of changes around this place, and that is for certain. Continuing coverage in Johnstown right now, the groundbreaking of Intel's $20 billion semiconductor plant. It's shining a spotlight on an area that until this point has been the postcard for small town America. So how do people who live here feel about what will be a seismic change for their community? Kate Seifert caught up with many neighbors to see how they're feeling about today's presidential visit and what will happen next to their town. Without a doubt, in this area of Central Ohio, farming is a way of life for so many families, and this development does mean a big adjustment to a new reality. Luke Garrett and his family have farmed land here in Lincoln County for over a century. Luke owns about 100 acres, another 600 acres owned by his father. And he tells us the big concern here is what this new plant will do to property values and, of course, the taxes.
There could come a point where property values get to be so high and therefore property taxes are going to reflect that, to where we can't justify paying the taxes and remaining in agricultural use.
Luke says he is already making some backup plans, trying to expand into neighboring Knox County just in case Johnstown and Lincoln County become too expensive to continue to operate. We are taking some of these very serious concerns straight to Lieutenant Governor John Houston today. We're going to speak with him live coming up in our 8 o'clock hour of Good Day Columbus on Fox 28, asking him about the incentives that were used to lure Intel to Ohio. Also, where were the workers that will build and operate that plant, those 7,000 workers? Where will they come from? And as you know, there's a shortage of housing in Central Ohio. So where are people going to live? That's all coming up this morning for you at 8 o'clock on Fox 28. For now, let's get back to Mike Kilburn with a look at your Friday morning traffic.
You're watching- watching Good Day Columbus on Fox 28.
Right now at 7:30, excitement is building as we await the arrival of Air Force One. As we give you a live look at John Glenn International, President Biden will be touching down there this morning. We have live team coverage of his visit and the groundbreaking for the Intel plant in Licking County. Good morning to all of you. Thank you so much for joining us. It is Friday, September 9th. We appreciate you being here. I'm Jessica Ralston, live in Johnstown.
And I'm Kurt Ludlow. We're going to get to our team coverage of that Intel groundbreaking and the president's visit in just a minute.
Today, President Biden's victory lap on several major legislative wins in Congress is coming through Central Ohio. Let's give you another live look here at the White House. The president will leave around 9 o'clock, so about an hour and a half to go, and he will make his way here to the groundbreaking of Intel's semiconductor plant in Licking County. The plan is that he will talk about what his administration is doing to boost American manufacturing. Intel committed to building that plant here with help from the federal government. That funding is coming from the CHIPS Act, which President Biden just signed into law last month. The president's involvement in this groundbreaking shows just how major of a moment this is for Ohio. Mike McCarthy is live at John Glenn International awaiting the president's touchdown today. And Mike, this project has been a priority on all levels. We're talking from here in Licking County to the State House in Columbus and to Washington, D.C. All right, Mark, of course, all of this pomp and circumstances playing out in the backdrop of the 2022 midterm elections. Ohio right in the middle of a highly competitive U.S. Senate race, and that's getting attention from two of the biggest political forces in American politics. Here's where that race stands right now. The average of polls from 538 Democratic candidate Representative Tim Ryan holds a razor-thin lead right now with 45%. Republican candidate author J.D. Vance coming in at 43%. Again, those are an average of polls. The race is bringing former President Donald Trump to Ohio as well. Now, he plans to campaign in Youngstown, which is the hometown and district of Congressman Ryan that he represents there in Northeast Ohio. Trump will campaign for Vance in what he calls a Save America rally. That will be held September 17th at the Gavelli Center at 7 at night. You can only register up to 2 tickets per mobile number, and those will come on a first-come, first-served basis. We have a link on how to register for that rally on myfox28columbus.com. We are going to have continuing coverage throughout the day of President Biden's visit to Ohio and this Intel groundbreaking. We're going to bring it to you live on our sister station, ABC 6, as the president arrives at John Glenn International and again when he speaks to the crowd in Licking County. If you're going to be away from your TV today and you still want to join in, make sure you have the Fox 28 News app on your phone. We'll send out a push alert with live streams to your phone the moment things get started. Kurt, it is going to be a historic day in Licking County and for the state of Ohio. Our coverage continues on Good Day Columbus at 8.
You're watching Good Day Columbus on Fox 28.
Right now to 8 a.m., we are getting closer to the moment we have been talking about for the last 9 months, the groundbreaking ceremony for Intel's new plant in Licking County set to start in just 2 hours from now. And as you can see here live, visitors are already beginning to arrive. Let's also take you live to the White House this hour. President Biden packing up and getting ready to head to Joint Base Andrews. That's where he will board Air Force One, his destination, Central Ohio, where he will participate in today's event in Licking County. Good morning. Thanks for joining us on this Friday, September 9th. We appreciate you being with us. I'm Jessica Ralston, live here in Johnstown, where this project is taking place just a few miles down the road.
And good morning. I'm Kurt Ludlow. We'll get to our team coverage. We're going to start this morning first with your first warning forecast and your steer clear team traffic.
You're watching Good Day Columbus on Fox 28.
Right now to 8 a.m., we are getting closer to the moment we have been talking about For the last 9 months, the groundbreaking ceremony for Intel's new plant in Licking County set to start in just 2 hours from now. And as you can see here live, visitors are already beginning to arrive. Let's also take you live to the White House this hour. President Biden packing up and getting ready to head to Joint Base Andrews. That's where he will board Air Force One, his destination, Central Ohio, where he will participate in today's event in Licking County. Good morning. Thanks for joining us on this Friday, September 9th. We appreciate you being with us. I'm Jessica Ralston, live here in Johnstown, where this project is taking place just a few miles down the road.
And good morning. I'm Kurt Ludlow. We'll get to our team coverage. We're going to start this morning first with your first warning forecast and your steer clear team traffic.
Johnstown is shining in the spotlight today. Intel breaking ground on a massive project that is being billed as a game changer for Ohio's economy. Attending the event, local and state leaders, along with President Joe Biden. Here's what we've been told about Intel's plans for Licking County. The company will invest $20 billion in the chip plant, creating 3,000 permanent positions. And keep in mind, many of those are high-paying six-figure jobs. And to build the plant, 7,000 construction jobs and support jobs will be created. We're talking about a ripple effect of folks who will work in restaurants, healthcare, housing, even entertainment. They're hoping to have this facility open by 2025. And Intel says this project could only happen with help from the federal government, which has pitched in billions of dollars. President Biden will be here to celebrate not only this facility, but also what he calls a big win for his economic agenda. Mike McCarthy is live at John Glenn International Airport this morning. And Mike, the president will be there in just a couple of hours now. All right, Mike, this project is coming with promises, but also concerns from the community. You've asked a lot of questions. We're working to get answers. Kurt is live in the studio this morning, continuing our team coverage.
All right, Jessica, thank you.
Continuing coverage now in Johnstown of the groundbreaking of Intel's $20 billion semiconductor plant. It's shining a spotlight on an area that until this point has been the postcard for small town America. So how do the people who live here feel about what will naturally be a seismic change for their community? Kate Seifert caught up with many who talked about how they're feeling about today's presidential visit and what will happen next to their town. Not everyone is celebrating the arrival of President Biden in Licking County today. Driving around the area, you can see some anti-Biden signs along the road. We have one man on the corner here holding a Trump sign and one man behind me holding a Trump sign. There are also protests happening today along Beach Road, so we will make sure that we follow those throughout the day as well. Let's check in with Caroline for a look at your Friday forecast.
You're watching Good Day Columbus on Fox 28.
Right now, we are awaiting the arrival of Air Force One. Let's give you a live look here at John Glenn International Airport. A lot of security on hand, which is protocol. President Biden expected to touch down there a little later on this morning. We do have live team coverage of his visit and the big groundbreaking for the Intel plant here in Licking County. Once again, good morning to all of you. Thank you so much for joining us on this Friday, September 9th. I'm Jessica Ralston, live in Johnstown this morning.
And I'm Kurt Ludlow. We're going to get to our Intel team coverage in just a minute. First, though, let's get to your first warning weather and your steer clear team traffic.
Happening today, President Biden's victory lap on several major legislative wins in Congress is coming through Central Ohio. Looking live, though, at the White House, the president expected to leave in just about 30 minutes, scheduled around 9 a.m. He will make his way here to the groundbreaking of Intel's semiconductor plant in Licking County. He is expected to talk about what his administration is doing to boost American manufacturing. Intel committed to building the plant here with major help from the federal government. That funding is coming from the CHIPS Act, which President Biden just signed into law last month. The president's involvement in this groundbreaking shows just how major of a moment this really is for Ohio. Mike McCarthy is live at John Glenn this morning awaiting the president's touchdown. And Mike, this project has been a priority on all levels from here in Licking County to the State House in Columbus and to the White House. We will have that continuing coverage throughout the day of President Biden's visit to Ohio and this Intel groundbreaking. We're going to bring it to you live on our sister station, ABC 6, as the president arrives at John Glenn International. Mike just mentioned that. And then again, when he speaks here where I'm at in Lincoln County. And if you're going to be away from your TV today, make sure you have the Fox 28 News app on your phone. We're going to send you a push alert with live streams straight to your phone the moment things begin here today. It is a very busy morning, a historical day for Licking County, Kurt, and really the state of Ohio.
You're absolutely right, Jessica. Thank you. It's 8:37 here.
President Biden calling Columbus the home of America's future. Pretty big deal as Intel brings its $20 billion computer chip factory to our very own state.
Today, the president traveling to Licking County to attend the formal groundbreaking. Jessica Ralston has been out there live all morning in Johnstown waiting for his arrival. Good morning, Jessica.
Well, good morning to both of you. Yeah, the president's scheduled to leave in Air Force One around right now, 9 o'clock in the morning, making his way here to Licking County, Ohio, for this day in history, the groundbreaking of Intel's $20 billion plant in Licking County, just a few miles down the road from where I am at here, live in Johnstown this morning. This is small town America, and it is about to have a very different reality with the influx of a massive fabrication plant and thousands of new jobs coming into the area. We're talking about Intel's project that will bring almost 10,000 jobs, 7,000 in construction alone and related trades. And then following that, once the plant is built around 2025, 3,000 permanent jobs, many of those high paying in the six-figure range. It is going to change the landscape of Licking County really forever. A lot of people will be moving here. Schools will change. Infrastructure will have to change. And while not all neighbors are ready for it or happy about it because they wanted to enjoy this small town rural life, it is a huge, huge impact on Ohio's economy and progress moving forward. So President Biden is expected to talk to the public about his role in all of this around 10:30 this morning as after they break ground there at the plant. We're talking about a 1,000 acre site in Licking County. It is the biggest plant in Intel's fold. And again, they put a $20 billion investment into this, but they also needed state and federal funds to make this happen as well. The president just recently signing off on the CHIPS Act, which included funding specifically for this plant. No word on how much money the plant is going to be getting from the CHIPS Act, but it is a significant amount. We're talking billions of dollars. That groundbreaking set to start around 10 o'clock this morning, and there are a lot of chairs set up there. State, local, national leaders will be on hand for this ceremony, as well as the folks from Intel, everyone talking about the excitement of this day and what it means for the future of Ohio. The president is scheduled to be there around 10:30 this morning. Again, he's going to be speaking. He calls Columbus, you heard it, the home of the future. And they're calling this the Silicon Valley of the Heartland. This is the largest single private sector investment in the history of Ohio. And when you think about the fast track that this has been on, Intel initially approached the state back in May of 2021. So we're talking just a little more than a year ago and said Ohio's in the running for this, but it was not easy to get Intel to decide to build here. Lieutenant Governor John Houston said the state or the site here in New Albany was the only one the state could come up with for this kind of project because of all of the requirements and how steep they were. It was then in January of this year, 2022, when Intel gave the word and said, Ohio is it. We're going to be building there. And then the ball just really started rolling, bringing us here to this groundbreaking today. We will be live here throughout the day for the groundbreaking and the president's visit. We'll have team coverage right here on Fox 28 and over on ABC 6.